Wayne Hill starting off their 2016 football season in the Sunshine State, a visit to Pahokee. And the Wayne Hills offense would get going early. Get used to this. Brendan DeVera to Hunter Hayek gets some blocks on the outside and falls forward for the first down. Here's the running back, Luca Grave, spinning off tacklers and falling forward for another Wayne Hills first down. Going the other direction, DeVera right over center, falling across the goal line. Wayne Hills pulls to within 1 point. Now to the defensive side, trying to test the left side, and Jason Modak is there. Tyler Costello helping him out, and the defense gets a stop. Back to Grave on the ground. Look at the burst. Disregard the flag. Wayne Hills answers again, continuing to fight the boys from Florida. The defense gets involved again. Costello, the ankle tackle, able to avoid a bigger play. And then on offense, the big receiver, Evidence Njoku, over the top, falling into the pylon. You would see more of that throughout this season. Wayne Hills, though, does fall on the road in Florida by a score of 34-23. That would be the most points Pahokee would allow on the season, as they went undefeated to run the table and win the Florida State Championship. So no shame in the opening night loss.
These last 4 years have really taught me how to persevere through adversity and how to put aside common differences to achieve a common goal. And something I really think I'm going to take out of this is time management and, you know, really, you know, being a grown-up and being responsible for your own stuff, because, you know, you got to be responsible for practice. And the thing I'm going to miss most is probably pre-practice and specials, you know, hearing Wally J talk about, you know, us not trying and all that.
Okay, so football, all these 4 years, it was a crazy ride with all my best friends. I made lifelong friends during these 4 years. You know, I'm gonna really take away all the hard work and determination throughout my life and anything that I do. You know, and probably the best memories that I had were making fun of Dario when no one clapped for him, and he went up to get his stickers, and the Fat Man 7-on-7. That was a fun time.
Wayne Hills returning home to New Jersey to take on the Ramapo Green Raiders. The defense gets going early. Look at Luca Grave on the edge, wrapping up the receiver for no gain. The Wayne Hills defense would be the story in this one. And then Grave again on special teams this time, able to find that far sideline with the football and get into Ramapo territory. Wayne Hills looking to draw even. That would set up this. Watch this throw from DeVera. Straight over the top on the money to Hunter Hayek for the 46-yard touchdown strike. And Wayne Hills draws even at sevens. The defense continues to be the story. Kai Sally plugging up the middle. No gain there for Ramapo. They would get it deep into Wayne Hills territory, but on fourth and goal, the front holds strong, and the Patriots keep the game deadlocked at seven. In the second quarter now, Mike Zaccone jumps the route and takes the interception into Ramapo territory, where he's finally knocked out of bounds inside the Green Raider 35-yard line. First turnover forced by Wayne Hills. DeVera now will scramble to the far side. Look at him tiptoe the sideline, gets the block from Luca Grave, and the speed of Brendan DeVera takes care of the rest all the way to the house for the long touchdown run, 60 yards down the sideline. Patriots have the lead, and another interception from a middle linebacker. Tyler Costello tips it to himself. Watch the replay. Up in the air, and he comes down with the football. What an acrobatic play by Costello, and the Patriots continue to lead by seven. In the monsoon now, late in the third quarter, that Wayne Hills front seven is mean. Gang tackling the Raiders running back, nothing they can do offensively. Now backed up in their own end zone, a bobble on the snap, nothing doing as DeVera comes up to make that stop. Ramapo desperate for points late in the fourth quarter. The last chance heave over the top, Tyler Hayek, too much height, up over the top, makes the interception at midfield. That's three interceptions for Wayne Hills on the day. DeVera puts on the finishing touches with the knee. He's fired up. Patriots beat their longtime rival Ramapo 14-7, and their record evens up at 1-1.
Being in the program 4 years taught me a lot. Taught me how to be a man, how to be on time for everything, how to show up early. I'm really going to take away that fighting adversity means a lot. Getting kicked out of the playoffs, that feeling is awful. But then the feeling of beating crosstown rivals in the state championship in overtime, never felt better than that. My best memory is probably making the first tackle at MetLife. After my junior year, I got injured, and that just showed me how much the program has taught me to overcome things that most people cannot overcome and play the best I can.
What I'm gonna take away from being a Wayne Hills football Patriot is definitely becoming a better man, learning how to manage my time, be a better person with the team and with teammates. Also the way to fight adversity. The whole season we had adversity and we never backed down once. We fought back from games, off-field problems, and it's really just taught me to become a better man and to fight for the person next to me. My best memories here playing football is definitely being with the team and all the teammates. It's like family, but if I had to say a game, it would probably be Roxbury, or even the Wayne Valley game the first time we played them, where Luca got hurt and I had to step up at running back. It was definitely a great experience, and even at MetLife, it was that fourth down play was ridiculous. And when I made that play and I threw it back to Brennan, I hoped for the best, and he made that play, and we ended up winning because the screw up dropped the ball. But yeah, it's definitely been a wonderful time here, and I hate that it's gonna end.
Week 3 of the regular season, Wayne Hills on the road in New Jersey for the first time all year, taking on the Roxbury Gales. The quarterback also plays defense. Brendan DeVera flattening the Roxbury back. Nick Petrecko falls on the loose football. Wayne Hills gets an early turnover. Then it's DeVera off the edge. Look at the pursuit. Getting to the Roxbury quarterback and picking up the sack, knocking the Gales inside their own 5. Then it's the offense. Luca Grave, a 4-yard touchdown scamper off of right tackle, and the Patriots have an early 7-0 lead. Hunter Haya catches this pass in the flat, gets the block from the running back Grave, and Hunter Haya has an easy touchdown in the first half against Roxbury. Now Wayne Hill special teams continues to be a high point for the team as the younger brother, Jaron Hayek, fields the kickoff off the bounce and is able to get through the Roxbury kickoff team and fall forward towards midfield. Big return from the youngster. Now it's the defense, fourth down, and Omar Sobrebov, the big Russian, makes the sack, and that would be the first of many plays for him in this game. This time, ripping the running back to the turf. And it's Sobrebov again on this running play, getting to the outside and making the tackle for a loss. Got a little help from his friends. Sobrebov, a monster game defensively for Wayne Hills on the road. Now it's DeVera, the big arm, all the way to Hunter Hayek inside the Roxbury 30. That was a big pass. They needed it. Wayne Hills trailing at this point. Now it's DeVeras rolling and looking over the middle, finds Tyler Hayek, who's running free inside the 10, able to duck in for the touchdown, and Wayne Hills gets a much-needed score. So Wayne Hills down 7, heavy pressure coming from Roxbury. DeVeras stands tall and gets the pass off to Tyler Hayek again. This time he takes the sideline route and weaves through some Gale defenders, going all the way to the end zone for the 42-yard touchdown. Wayne Hills ties the game. Then more pressure coming from Roxbury, and DeVera gets off a good throw to Jaron Hayek, who's able to tiptoe the sideline and stay in bounds. Defense needs a stop here, and Tyler Hayek cleans up the Roxbury receiver, forces a Roxbury punt, and Wayne Hills their last chance. DeVera goes over the top, and a diving catch from Jaron Hayek gives Wayne Hills the lead. The comeback is complete. Patriots score late to take the advantage on Roxbury. Last chance for the Gales. Nobody home on the near sideline, and Wayne Hills gets an emotional comeback victory on the road, 42-35 the final.
It's taught me a lot of discipline, how to be on time, my work ethic, and I'm just going to take away all discipline, and it's helped me grow up throughout the years. I remember going to MetLife and playing in MetLife. It was a great experience, crazy game.
It means a lot to me. I mean, I have so many memories with all my boys, and what I'm going to take away a lot is all the hard work that I feel like I put into this, because This meant more than anything, and I couldn't be any happier to be a part of all this. I remember all the memories I'm going to have with all my friends that's going to last forever, and also I'm going to remember all the JV games, because those were a lot of fun, and also I'm going to remember all the playoff games, and most of all, win the state championship.
2-1 Wayne Hills returning home to take on the team that knocked him out of the state finals a year ago, Old Sapan. And Brendan DeVero would start this game with a bang over the top to Hunter Hayek for this 34-yard touchdown. And then the defense makes some plays. Petracco and Sobrebov with the big stop. And watch this play. This is just absurd. From midfield off the back foot, DeVero to Grave, who plays center field and comes down with the football inside the 5-yard line. That would set up the go-ahead touchdown for Wayne Hills. Game tied again in the second, coming near side this time to Grave on the curl route, and he does the rest. Gets a good block from Hayek, and Wayne Hills takes a touchdown lead. Up by 9 now, the defense coming at the quarterback, and Jason Modak shows no mercy. Big-time sack, knocking Old Sapan back into their own territory. And another big defensive play here, with Hills nursing a 9-point lead, Old Sapan threatening, and DeVera knocks the ball loose. Wayne Hills with a monster red zone turnover. Still up by 9. Here's the kicker, Dario Cierney, on for a 37-yard field goal. It's good. Just enough leg from Cierney, and the Patriots have a 12-point lead. Wayne Hills up 12 after a touchdown, going for the 2-point conversion. Look at DeVera egging on the defenders and then finding Hayek in the end zone. That's Tyler Hayek on the 2-point conversion. Wayne Hills still in trouble, though, only up 7. And look at DeVera, the fake punt. I don't know if Coach called that, but that takes some cojones. What a run from DeVera. Gets the first down and puts the game on ice. Wayne Hills gets revenge on Old Sapan with a 34-27 win at home.
This program's meant the world to me. It's definitely shaped me into the person I am today. What I'm going to take away is definitely the brotherhood aspect, the camaraderie we've built together. And I think I'm going to miss, honestly, just being out there with everybody every day. I'm going to remember it for my lifetime.
So I was only here for 2 years, and it was probably the best 2 years of my life, I guess. And through like these two seasons, I'm really just gonna take away like all the hard work and just like see like how hard our coaches work, and I'm just gonna like take that into like life and then onto the next level and just do what my coaches showed me and taught me what to do. The thing I'm gonna miss the most is probably gonna be off the field, is walking past the Valley student section, just waving to them.
Wayne Hills back at home in week 5 to take on Milburn. And if you're wondering why we're showing you all these extra points, I promise you there's a reason. Keep a close eye on the number in the bottom left of the screen. This is Wayne Hills kicker Dario Cierney, and he's a good one. Watch the numbers go up. This is number 6 against Milburn. You get the idea of what kind of game this was. Number 7, that's enough, right? 7 extra points. Here's number 8. That ties a Wayne Hills school record for PATs in a single game. You see it there on your screen. Cierney with 8 extra points. That should tell you all you need to know about this game. Wayne Hills coming out of the smoke as usual at home against Milburn, and this was a chance for the Patriots to show off their high-octane offense. First play from scrimmage. Brendan DeVera is going to be in a different zip code by the time this play is over. 7-0 Wayne Hills, one play in. And then on the ensuing kickoff, look out for Anthony Puntalillo, the special team specialist, cleaning up the play and pinning Milburn inside their own 20-yard line. The defense would keep it going. Big hit from Brendan DeVera in the backfield. A loss on that play for Milburn. And here is DeVera on offense, going on the far sideline to Evidence Njoku. The big receiver headed to Miami makes the catch. Now they come to the near side on the very next play. Hunter Hayek finds the sideline, gets a couple blocks, 22-yard reception there. That would set up this. The cease part for Luca Grave, 14-0 Wayne Hills. Patriots looking for more. DeVera over the top, wide open is Njoku for the touchdown. And then going the other direction, Luca Grave with the speed, cuts it back inside and gets into the Milburn red zone. DeVera this time will call his own number, spinning up the middle and into the end zone. Patriots lead 28-0. More DeVera on defense again. Grave joins him for the big hit in the backfield, and Devera, with all day to throw this time, gets hit from behind as he lets it fly, but it's on the money. Hunter Hayek makes the catch. That's a 47-yard connection. Still 28-0 Wayne Hills. It's an interception. Hunter Hayek at midfield brings that ball in. And before the half, Hill's looking for more. Devera over the middle, and a tough catch made by Luca Grave. 20-yard completion sets up a touchdown, 35-0 Wayne Hills. Right back at him. Over the middle, it's Hayek again. Another touchdown strike for Wayne Hills, 42-0. Cue the backups. Here comes JoJo Mangeli to the far side, and the sophomore has six inside the far pylon. Patriots piling on. 49-0, and look out for Zach Zachman blowing it up in the backfield, and check out the flow. All about the flow. Zachman makes the play. The defense gobbles up the running back. Give credit to Nasufi and Rodriguez on that hit. And remember, Zachman, it's all about the flow. Interception this time. Zachman the other way, getting free from defenders inside the Milburn 30. Zach Zachman, that's a backup, folks. Kid can play. This is Jaron Hayek in at quarterback, gets the seal on the outside. He gets the touchdown run. That caps the scoring. J.P. Lemchek, the future of the program, takes the knee. And Wayne Hills with a routine 56-0 win.
My time in the program has been unbelievable. I've learned more than my fair share of lessons just from like getting in a little bit of trouble and like learning from it. And like I think it's changed me as a man for the most part. Just like punctuality and like preparedness and all that stuff. What I'm gonna take away, like I definitely think I grew up, and I think it added on to like my toughness just overall. Memories, I'm definitely gonna miss like messing around in the dorms at ESU and like rain games for sophomore games, JV games, night games, like JV games against Valley, and like getting in every now and then varsity games, running through the tunnel at MetLife. Like I can go forever. It's just like all stuff that I'm gonna remember forever.
This program definitely meant the world to me, going out there every day with my brothers. No place I'd rather play. And some things I'll keep with me for the rest of my life are definitely the hard work that I learned through the program. Never quit, keep going, because at the end it's all worth it as long as you give it everything you got. And one thing I'll never forget was that last whistle in Giants Stadium when all the hard work finally paid off and I knew we were going to get a ring. I'll remember that for the rest of my life.
So Wayne Hills starting the season at 4-1, going on the road in week 6 to take on usual rival Pascack Valley, but this was not your grandmother's PV team. Kai Sally and Brennan Devera combine on this stop. The Indians offense couldn't get anything going in week 6. The offensive star in this game for Wayne Hills was Luca Grave. The running back galloping outside to the right on this play, picking up 27 yards. That would set up Evidence Njoku for not one, but two touchdowns. This is the first one very easy. The second one, not so much. Tiptoes the back corner of the end zone, falls into the band, and Wayne Hills has a 14-7 lead on the back of Njoku. Here comes the defense again. Brendan Devera knocking the ball loose. The PV quarterback would be done for the day. Back to Grave now. He's fast, but we're going to make him even faster. Fast forward the touchdown run for Grave. They call it back due to penalty, but still more than a 50-yard gain because the penalty was downfield. That would set up this Hunter Hayek touchdown reception, who tiptoes down the sideline for 20 yards. Wayne Hills up 21-0. And this also not a replay. Hunter Hayek gets the swing route, going to get a good block from his brother, and he's gone. 33 yards, Wayne Hills leads 28-0 at the half. The defense continued what they were doing. Jason Modak pushing the pile here with some help from his friends. This time it's all Modak, overpowering the blocker and smothering the PV quarterback. Big time sack from the defensive end. We'll switch back over to offense. Luca Grave continuing to do what he does. They give him the screen on this play, and take a look at this series of moves from the Wayne Hills running back. Shaking PV defenders and still on his feet all the way into the Indians red zone. What a run for Grave. And here's some more Modak. Finished the day with 7 tackles, 2 for a loss, and 2 sacks. For good measure, Devera over the middle, juggling catch from Luca Grave. And then another run from Luka. 31 yards on this play, 225 yards from scrimmage for number 22 in white. And to top it all off, how about a special teams touchdown? DeVera on the boot, eclipse the PV returner, and it's picked up in the end zone by who else? Luka Grave, the star of this game up north at PV. Wayne Hills takes it by a final of 42-14. They improve to 5-1.
I've been in this program for 4 years. It taught me a lot. I came here new. I didn't know what football was. I'm going to miss playing with my friends on Friday nights. It was fun. It taught me a lot how to be a better man, person, how to not give up, not quit. The best feelings was in my life. It was fun. I'm never going to forget that, how we won.
I'm definitely going to miss the times of my brothers playing out in the field, the practice, the games, the bonds that you make. I feel like they'll never be able, never could be broken. Football's taught me a lot of stuff, from mental toughness to, how to act as a man to other people. The courage that it's gave me, and just the overall, how to act on a daily basis. It just instilled that toughness in me. And I'm gonna miss it a lot. And I'm looking forward to go play in college, and just looking forward to keep the bonds with everyone else.
Wayne Hills returning home, running through their familiar smoke to take on local rival Passaic Valley in week number 7. The defense came out to play again. Right away, Danny Musa with a big stop. Tackle for a loss. PV's offense could get nothing going. This time, Costello and company with the big hit. The offense was good too. How easy is this? Evidence Njoku, a 45-yard touchdown catch from Brendan DeVera. Patriots lead 7-0. DeVera punting now. The ball is muffed. Wayne Hills falls on it. Hunter Hayek thinks he has a touchdown. That play, though, inexplicably reversed. The defense would make up for it, though. Jason Modak strips the ball carrier and falls on it himself. Key turnover for the Patriots. Back to offense. This is Luka Grave, able to shed a couple blockers and get to the far side. That is a 46-yard run. And back to the defensive line. Musa again. Kai Sally in there as well. Big stop for Wayne Hills' defense. Now DeVera back to work. Finds Tyler Hayek. Makes the corner miss. Gets a block. Gonna shift around the safety. And the speed does the rest. Tyler Hayek high stepping it into the end zone. And Wayne Hills has a 14-0 lead. Now leading 17-0 in the second half. Another good run from Grave, 28 yards to set up this touchdown pass to Evidence Njoku, who stands up tall to make the reception. He says, "Get off me." 4 touchdowns in 2 weeks against teams with the initials PV. You know who else likes playing PV? Jason Modak, his 4th sack in 2 weeks against a team initialed PV. Here's Grave again with a tough run. And now DeVera is going to roll to the right, throw across his body, and somehow find Hunter Hayek, who falls inside the 10-yard line. And DeVera is going to go right back to him. On the move, throws right and hits Hunter Hayek for the 26-yard touchdown. Wayne Hills extends their lead to 31-6, and that would be all the scoring they needed. Mike Zaccone with that big hit, and they limit PV to single digits. Wayne Hills is 6-1.
It's a lot to me, to come in the summer. I came to a different team for my senior year. I'm gonna miss the way the team took me in, as one of them, as one of their friends. Like, just the whole week of camp, the whole week of just summer training, we just bonded with the whole team. And I'm gonna miss the most of just talking to the coaches, Coach Jakes, Coach JJ, Coach Bat, Coach Dem even. Just them giving me advice on just recruiting stuff like that, just football in general, I feel like the thing I'm going to remember the most, and I won't forget, was just, the MetLife game, just the last 2 seconds when the refs blew the whistle, and just the faces on everybody's, the team, the coaches, the fans, it was something I'm never going to forget, so I'm just thankful to have gone out with a group of these boys, I can call true friends, and that was just, the result is priceless with the ring and everything. So.
Definitely time management. I remember Coach Dem always telling us the easiest thing in life to do is just be on time. I also remember as a freshman looking across the varsity field and seeing varsity players do certain drills and thinking like, wow, like how could we ever do those things? How could we ever hit like that? And actually getting there, I remember one of the first drills that we did that day, I went up against Joe Kenny, and I remember thinking if I don't go 100% on this one, I'm definitely getting put on my back, and I gave it all I had, and I couldn't believe like we actually stalemated. And I remember my head ringing, but like I remember nothing but excitement and energy pumping through my body, and I went after him again, and that one didn't work out too well, but it was nothing but raw energy, and just I loved the atmosphere I was in at that point. And I remember thinking, this is the atmosphere, this is what I really want, and it's gonna save me for a while, actually forever. And definitely the bonds and the relationship I've created here with friends. I mean, I got friends now that we look at each other and say, definitely going to college together, or definitely gonna stay together forever.
And now to the serious part of the Wayne Hill schedule. Across town to take on the rival Wayne Valley Indians, both teams with only one loss, a game full of emotion and big hits. Jason Modak gets this one, driving the running back all the way back to the line of scrimmage. And then it's Hunter Haya coming up from the safety position to make the sack and drive back the Indians on third down. Now DeVera to work for Wayne Hills, able to scramble and find space on the far sideline inside the Valley 30-yard line of Wayne Hills first down. Third and long now, DeVera rolling to his left, looking deep for Hunter Hayek. In double coverage, he holds it in and gets inside the pylon for the touchdown. Patriots a big score there, and then Nick Gould coughs it up. Jason Modak in quickly for the recovery. Wayne Hills would look towards the back pylon on this one, and DeVera on target. Hunter Hayek, an 11-yard touchdown reception. Wayne Hills within one. Another fumble, and then the stop by Modak. This time, Modak going after the quarterback. It's a strip sack. Kai Sally in for the recovery, and Wayne Hills gets a turnover. But now the Patriots in an 11-point hole before Modak picks up another sack, his third of the game, and seventh in 3 weeks. He finished with a season-high 11 tackles. Luca Grave got hurt. That's a big loss, but Hunter Hayek able to fill the void nicely. A long touchdown run there. He's figuring out this running back thing quick, a 15-yard carry. Wayne Hills, though, would have to punt, and check out this stop. Jaron Hayek able to get along the feet of the return man, and Chris Pasterla finishes him off, blasting the return man, and then another big play from the Wayne Hills defense. Omar, Kai Sally, DeVera on that stop, and Wayne Hills on third down, late in the fourth quarter, needs a first down, and it's Njoku picking it up on third and long after DeVera extended the play. Wayne Hills needs a touchdown down five. Now DeVera back to pass. Here's the screen over the middle. Tyler Hayek weaving through the Valley defense. He's in. Wayne Hills takes the lead late on Wayne Valley. It's a one-point lead. Valley needs yards quickly, and that means the Wayne Hills pass rushers can pin their ears back. Here comes Jason Modak for his third sack of the night. And then, not to be outdone, on fourth down, they fumble the snap, and here comes the unsung hero. Anthony Cusso finishes off crosstown rival Wayne Valley. The boys from Verdun go across town and stun the Indians on their home field, 25-24, the final. This would not be their last meeting in 2016.
The thing about Wayne Hills football, more than any program, really shows you that everything's earned, not just given. And it kind of forms us into these hardworking individuals, and it's gonna help us be successful one day. And that's something I really pulled from 4 years of Wayne Hills football, and I'm gonna continue to show throughout my life. Something I'm gonna miss, actually already miss, is being at practice every day with my brothers, from practice to games, scrimmages, really anything, just hanging out in the locker room.
Football has meant everything to me over the last 4 years. I mean, the last 4 years, we've done football nonstop. Everything has just kept going, and you grind every day. The thing I'm gonna take away most is probably the discipline.
where, you know, showing up every day, working hard, you know, every play, trying your hardest. Also, like the leadership, I really became a great leader through the football program, and it really taught me how to be a good role model towards people. Some of the best memories that I have are just being with my boys every day at ESU. There's nothing like spending 4 days with your best friends and playing your heart out on the field with them.
Wayne Hills finishing off the regular season against an unfamiliar foe, undefeated Irvington, coming to Wayne Hills High School. Hey, what's better than one Evidence Njoku kickoff return? How about two at the same time? Njoku sets up Wayne Hills in plus territory on their first two possessions, and Brendan DeVera knows what to do with it. Perfect slant over the middle to Tyler Hayek. His speed does the rest, and Wayne Hills ties the game at 7. This was an Irvington offense averaging better than 35 points per game coming into this one, but they haven't seen a defense like Wayne Hills before. Danny Musa playing hurt makes the big stop. Then Jaron Hayek sets up the receiver. Brendan DeVera punishes him. Now DeVera on offense, a patient run. How many quarterbacks have this kind of speed? A 75-yard scamper for DeVera all the way down to the Irvington 10-yard line. JoJo Mongelli, his first career varsity start, and he pushes his way across the goal line for 6. Wayne Hills takes the lead late in the first quarter. To the second now, Hills still up a touchdown. DeVera rolling right and finds a crazy angle to the back of the end zone, and it's the younger brother, Jaron Hayek, with a touchdown reception. Patriots lead by 2 touchdowns, and then it's Kai Sally dropping the quarterback, Javon Brown, for a massive loss. That was an 8-yard loss. And Wayne Hills up by a touchdown, going back to the air. End of the first half, Evidence Njoku, the over-the-shoulder catch, and the Patriots have a 27-13 lead at the break. Special teams, always a strength for Wayne Hills. Here is Chris Pasterla with the strip. Wayne Hills recovers, and they would put up some big numbers early in the second half. JoJo Mongelli patiently catching the screen pass, and he knew what to do with it. Mongelli's second touchdown of the game. That's a 12-yard receiving touchdown. Wayne Hills up 34-13. Brown over the middle. This time it's intercepted. Jaron Hayek catches that pass on defense. Wayne Hills smothering Irvington at the 1 this time. Zaccone, Pasterla in on that stop. And Mongelli, the star of this one, his third touchdown of the day. What a first varsity game for Mongelli. And then Wayne Hills just playing around. DeVera off the back foot finds Hunter Hayek on the 21-yard touchdown score. Hayek finished the night with 6 catches for 118 yards and 2 touchdowns. Hunter Hayek with 13 touchdowns in the regular season, all through the air to lead Wayne Hills. Patriots run the table in New Jersey. They finished the regular season 8-1.
So this program basically means everything to me. I was coming here since I was 3 years old watching these games. I've always wanted to be a Wayne Hills football player. And luckily we came out the way I wanted it with the state championship ring. But the thing I'm going to miss the most, besides playing with my boys, obviously, that's a cliche, but the thing I'm going to miss the most is honestly like the recognition. Like, we'd go scout teams and you see old ladies, like grandmas, like leaning over, whispering to the people they're with, saying, oh, that's Wayne Hills. You know, it's like wearing that W, you feel like you're famous. And that's, other than playing with my best friends for 4 years, that's the thing I'm going to miss the most.
Oh, this program means a lot to me. Just coming in the morning, that's all I did for 4 years. Like, that's everything I know. I remember the most, like, messing around with the coaches, me and Colot going at it every day. It's like the best feeling ever. I'm never gonna forget that play in MetLife when he dropped the ball, and like, I had no idea what was going on. I didn't know if he won, if he lost. Like, I didn't know what was going on. And I'll take away just like the hard work, just to be on time, be tough, all that stuff.
Wayne Hills wasn't sure if they'd be able to participate in the state playoffs, but after much commotion, the boys found themselves taking on 8th-seeded Roxbury in the first round, and they were fired up on a frigid day in North Jersey. All kinds of adrenaline on the Wayne Hills kickoff team, and on the first play, Anthony Puntalillo makes a big tackle, and this next play would be a microcosm of this game. Roxbury could do nothing against the Wayne Hills defense as the running back gets absolutely swallowed up by the Wayne Hills front. to offense now in a scoreless game. DeVera looking over the middle, and somebody forgot to cover Evidence Njoku. An easy 41-yard touchdown reception, and Wayne Hill's on top. Not every team has a 300-pound kickoff specialist, and not every team has a kicker who's willing to run 50 yards downfield to lay out the returner. Wayne Hills does. Bensie Pulgar absolutely flattens the Roxbury returner. Boy, that had to hurt. So we hear that Omar Sobrebov can cut some hair. Well, he also can cut down running backs. Big tackle for a loss on that play. Roxbury would have to punt. Wayne Hill's looking for another score. Going over the top, Tyler Hayek with a spectacular catch across the goal line. Wayne Hill's leads 14 to nothing. And then Jason Modak, the big defensive lineman with his 9th sack of the year. Roxbury moving backwards. DeVera back to work up by 2 scores. Off his back foot, call him Brendan DeVera Favre. Over the top to Njoku, who's open in the middle of the field. And DeVera Favre back at it again. This time finds Hunter Hayek across midfield, and he's into Roxbury territory on the 48-yard hookup. Did we mention it was 25 degrees with 20-mile-an-hour winds for this game? Didn't stop the Wayne Hills passing game. Hayek, another catch over the middle. That one good for 46 yards. And then it's Hunter again. DeVera scrambling, able to find him for this 6-yard touchdown catch. And the Patriots had a 21-0 lead at the half. And DeVera back to work again, this time in the 3rd quarter. Check out this grab. We'll go slow-mo for Evidence Njoku. 21 yards on the 10-yard line for that catch. And then Luca Grave, back from injury, does the rest. Able to turn the corner and get inside the pylon for the touchdown. 27-0 Wayne Hills. Roxbury in desperation mode, couldn't get the ball moving at all. Good stop by Tyler Costello. Jason Modak finishes it off. Wayne Hills will give up just 7 points in this one and having some fun on offense. Back of the end zone, Hunter Hayek tracks down the ball, keeps his feet in bounds. The Patriots win 33-7 at home. They march on to the state semis. Wayne Hills returning home with a trip to MetLife Stadium on the line in the state semifinals. Patriots taking the field in their all-black uniforms, getting set to face off with 9-1 West Morris. Right off the bat, 3rd and long, going over the middle of the Wolfpack are intercepted. Hunter Hayek on the pick, and Wayne Hills forces a turnover on their first offensive possession. Now it's Hunter's brother, Tyler Hayek, going to find some space to the outside. On the sweep play, his speed does the rest. Hayek breaks free for a 60-yard touchdown run, and Wayne Hill scores on their opening possession. Game now tied. DeVera rolling to his weak side. He finds Hunter Hayek on a 17-yard completion. Now DeVera under heavy pressure, able to check down to the screen route. And Luca Grave, shiftiness in the open field, gets into the end zone for the touchdown. Wayne Hill's up 14-7. Patriots defense sticking to their assignments. Great job by Omar and Kai Sally on that play. They try another running play. Danny Musa stuffs the run. Wayne Hills well schooled against the wing T offense. Here's a punt play now, and Luca Grave gonna have a nice return. Give him 37 yards before he shouldered out of bounds. DeVera now rolling to his right, gonna find Grave 17 more yards through the air. Now over the middle to Tyler Hayek for 16. Well, we had Brendan DeVera Favre. Now it's Evidence Njoku Beckham. The one-handed catch, are you kidding me? 11 yards of the spectacular variety. That gave Wayne Hills a first down. Late in the 2nd quarter, DeVera would not be denied. All the way to the goal line, pushes his way in. His 6th rushing touchdown of the season gives Wayne Hills the momentum going into halftime with a 21-7 lead. Wolfpack trying to answer on 4th down. They go towards the end zone. No chance. Well defended by DeVera. Wayne Hills forces a turnover. Back to the running game. Luca Grave up the middle. That's 15 yards for the Wayne Hills running back. And now DeVera, moving the pocket to his right, has all day to throw. Over the middle, touchdown Wayne Hills. Hunter Hayek over the top. His 10th consecutive game with a touchdown reception. And then it's Grave again. Another Wayne Hills first down. Trying to run out the clock in the fourth. De Vera rolling to his right, pointing to people. This is backyard football. Touchdown throw to Hunter Hayek. It's called back, but whatever. That kid's a stud. Now it's De Vera looking back over the middle. Has all day to throw. Nice job, offensive line. Coming back the other way. Still has time. Goes to the back of the end zone to Tyler Hayek. Well, he dropped it, but you know, he's a stud too. Speaking of studs, Dario Cierney lining up a 41-yard field goal attempt, and this one is good. Wayne Hills has a big-time kicker, and he finishes off the West Morris Wolfpack, extending the lead to 31-14. Now all the defense had to do was hold tough. West Morris forced to do something they are very unfamiliar doing, and that's throw the football. De Vera, a beautiful pass defense there, going to the far side. That one's a little bit too long. Last chance for West Morris, that pass to no one in particular, and Wayne Hills is headed back to the state championship game. A 31-14 win in the state semis over West Morris, and the team waiting, Wayne Valley. Wayne Hills back in MetLife Stadium looking to avenge their state championship loss against Old Tappan in 2015 with a win in 2016 against crosstown rival Wayne Valley. No love lost between these two teams, and the Wayne Hills secondary came out of the gates hot. Sophomore Jaron Hayek over the top to make the interception on Grant Ferrullo. But we're not going to lie to you, Wayne Hills came out sluggish. This will be a nice play by Jason Modak, but Wayne Valley would score and open up a 10-0 lead, and they needed this. It's Modak again on the fumble recovery this time, and Wayne Hills down 10 gets outstanding field position. That would set up this. Luca Grave punches it in from 3 yards out, and Wayne Hills pulls to within 3, although they'd be down 10 at the half. Late in the third, Wayne Hills needs some semblance of offense, and they're going to get it here. De Vera over the middle, able to hit Hunter Hayek for a Wayne Hills first down. That's a gain of 23. That would set up this. Dario Cierney, 28-yard field goal is good, and Wayne Hills within a score. It's 17-10 Valley, but now 24-10. Wayne Hills defense needs to step up, and they do. They smother Greg Peloso for a loss, and Hills gets the ball back. Third and long now for De Vera. They need a first down desperately, and De Vera threads the needle. Tyler Hayek over the middle, uses his speed to break free, and Hills gets a much-needed touchdown. Patriots are within 7. De Vera finishes the season with 37 passing touchdowns, the most in a single season in Wayne Hills history. Patriots need another stop, and they get it. Hunter Hayek deflects that ball and forces Wayne Valley to punt again. Hills gets the ball down 7, and they go to the screen option. Over the middle, Luca Grave gonna get to the far side, navigating through blockers. Each receiver throws a block. Still going down the sideline, Luca Grave goodbye. Touchdown Wayne Hills, they're an extra point away. The senior running back with a monstrous play, and here is Mr. Automatic. Dario Cierney with the extra point, and the Patriots come from behind to tie the game. Valley looking to answer on third and long. Montero drops the football. Wayne Hills with a stop. But after they can't score, Wayne Valley has the last chance. Over the middle is Ferrullo, and that one's knocked away. So an initial stop from Tyler Hayek and company. But after a Wayne Valley first down, they're knocking on the door for field goal range. But not before this huge sack from Jason Modak, who finishes the season with 11 sacks. Over the middle on fourth down, and it's incomplete. Intended for Montero, Wayne Hills with another big stop, and we would go to overtime. In the extra session, playing for the state title, Luca Grave spins off a tackler and gets 4. Third and 6, Hills over the middle, incomplete. Off the hands of Tyler Hayek. Fourth down, last chance for Wayne Hills. Pay attention. Statue of Liberty play. Hayek gets blown up, but somehow he flips it to De Vera. Coming to the near side, he turns the corner, stays in bounds, and gets the first down. Are you kidding me? Wayne Hills moves the chains, and they still have a chance to score in overtime. Now to Grave on the ground inside the Valley 10, pushing forward to the 5. Hills is set up. Now they pack everybody in. Back to Grave, left side, he gets in. Touchdown Wayne Hills. They punch it in for 6 on their first overtime possession. Extra point is good. Valley will have to score a touchdown or Wayne Hills has a miraculous state title. First play for Wayne Valley. Ferullo over the top to Peloso, catches the football and coughs it up. It's across the pylon and out of bounds. The refs get together and it is ruled a touchback. Wayne Hills wins the state championship on a walk-off touchback. Oh my goodness, Miracle at the Meadowlands Part 2, crown those boys. State champions, Wayne Demikoff, his first since taking over the program, and it is one to remember. A game for the ages, and the Patriots walk off with a 31-24 overtime win against Wayne Valley.